what we are going to do now is to understand certain best practices about drawing these pie charts and bar charts, what we have learned so far. Now, even before we actually go and understand about what is required from a bar chart and pie chart or a pie chart or a frequency table, the first thing we need to understand is what is the purpose. Now, when I say purpose, it does not mean or it does not necessarily mean that every data set should convey a message. What is the purpose? We ask our question, what is the purpose? For example, if I just have a data, say I have a data which is A, I have A, B, C, A, B, D, E, A, or D, A, B, B. This is just a categorical data. Now, if I have this data, now the questions I need to ask is, what is the purpose of this data? Suppose this data is just a set of states and nothing more than that. Suppose this is Andhra Pradesh, this is Bihar, this is Chhattisgarh and all of that. And I am looking at, I am collecting data of, or I am asking every person who is entering a particular room which state they belong to, and this is the data I have. Now, once I collect this data, I need to understand what are the questions I want to ask from the data. The first thing is, if I want to just tabulate this data. So, I look at it, I prepare a table like the way we discussed in the last time. I say, okay, people from state A, people from state B, people from state D, people from state D. This is the category I am looking at. And then after, so I have the count, which I call it as also the frequency. Once I have this count, this could be say 1, 2, 3, I have 3. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, C is just 1 and D is 2. So, this is the way I construct what is called a frequency table. So, now the question is, what is the purpose? From this, if my purpose is just to count and represent it as a table, I go in for a frequency table. However, if my purpose is to come up with a tabulation, I want to compare how each state does with the other, then I might want to go for a bar chart, because bar chart helps me in comparison. However, if my purpose is to know how, what is the share of each state, then I will go in for relative frequencies, which is depicted by a pie chart. So, what we are going to do today is to first understand when to use a pie chart. You use a pie chart when you are trying to compare parts of a whole. So, if I have a class of say 100 students and I want to know what is the regional distribution, then after the pie chart is the right chart for me to use to compare this. However, if I want to compare things, I want to know what is the exact count of how many are from each region, then a bar chart is more appropriate. So, the first thing before, when would you use a table? We would use a table when we are interested. Suppose I have a lot of categories, then what would happen is both the bar chart and pie chart would appear to be entirely cluttered. If I want to represent the entire data, then perhaps a table is more appropriate. So, even before we go to summarize data, the first question we need to ask is, what is the purpose of my summary analysis? What is it I want to convey? Choose the table or graph to serve this purpose. The next very important thing is, once we, what we saw in the earlier class was how to create both the bar chart and the pie chart. Now, we are going to spend some time to understand how to label the bar charts or how to label the charts. So, even before we label the chart, so now let me just go back to our Google sheet and type in a particular data. Suppose this is the data I have just typed in. So, I can I just want to create a chart of this data. So, I go to insert, I go to chart, and you can see that I have a pie chart which is inserted here. Now, within the pie chart, you can see that I have a tab which says it is customized, and that is on your right hand corner. Now, you can see that here this pie chart, I have what are the pie slices. I know I can put up a title. This title is something, currently the title is count. I can just put a title which says distribution or some grades. If A, B, C, D represent grades, I can just say distribution of grades. Now, typically if you want a subtitle, you can add a subtitle. From now, I am just adding a subtitle which is region, just for the sake of it. And you can see the distribution of grades region appears here. Now, it always helps us to just then look at what are the legends you want. You can put the legend wherever you want, and I am sure that we will have a separate tutorial to actually tell how different legends would look later. But at this point of time, what I want you to tell is, you can see what is the color, whether it is auto, and you can keep adding the colors and the text colors, or you can just put it auto, the title font size. You can look at what are the chart, this one, and suppose I put 25, you can see that you are actually moving a particular slice out of the particular thing. One point I want to make here, what I want to clarify is, when you are putting, clicking two colors is not advisable, because when you click two colors, it is really, you do not have any change between these two colors. So, it is always advisable to retain one particular color. Now, suppose I do the same thing for each of these pie slices. I go and I do each of them. This, even though it is possible, you see that this does not make any sense. The reason why a chart like this does not make any sense is, it is not actually the reason, the purpose of a pie chart is to help you understand what is the share of a pie. Now, when just for decorative purposes, if people start demonstrating it this way, you can see that this does not actually convey what you want to say. So, I would strongly advise against a visualization where you are actually moving every pie slice. Rather, I would prefer that, unless essential, do not have to change the distance from the center, and have everything maintained so far, we have a nice pie chart. Again, this would tell us how to label it, whether you want it in the label, what is the font size, you can, and whether you want it as a in italics, or whether you want it bold. You can see as I keep changing it, it is changing here. So, all of that you can do it later. Now, another thing is, well, if you want borders, you can add a border. Adding a border would always help us. You can always decide whether you want a border or not. There is something else in the layout which is called a 3D. Again, I do not think the 3D is giving us any extra value, but you can always have a pie chart as a three-dimensional chart also. You use it whenever you want it, but in my opinion, a simple pie chart conveys more than what is essential. So, this is about how you are going to come up with chart title, chart subtitle, and what are the default size for each pie slice. You can see what is the distance from the center. You can customize it, and then after, you can add values whenever you want. You can switch rows and columns here, but here, since I have only one column, I do not have to do that. Now, the same thing, the same data I can choose here. For the same data, I can choose the chart, which I call a bar chart or a column chart here. Now, again in a column chart, I can customize the column chart. First thing, I add the subtitle and title. I can add the chart title. Again, I am going to add the chart title as regional distribution, assuming this are A, B, C, D's are regions. I can add a subtitle if I want to. Here I need to add a horizontal axis title. In the horizontal axis title, I can just add region because my A, B, C, D are actually representing regions. Again, within a region, I can tell what is the font I needed. If I need a very big font size and if I need it in bold, I can do all those things here. I also have a vertical axis. In the vertical axis, I just add a count. In the vertical axis, this count is given. So, this count is given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, another thing which I would like to add is I can add data labels. By data labels, it tells me actually what is the number of counts or observations for each category. Now, this auto labels can be in any size, too big, or it can be 5. The text color, I can choose the text color I need for my data labels, and I also can tell what is the position. I always prefer it at the outside end, or I can have it at the inside base, wherever you want. This I am not going to have, there is no particular actual to be done it, or this is what you can have. You can see that you have the region with the distribution which is at the outer end. So, what the first thing which we need to understand is, be it a pie chart or a bar chart, first thing is to label or annotate your data, because only when we label or annotate the data, there is a better visualization or it communicates the idea better. So, here again, if these were A, B, C, D, I have labeled my chart distribution of grades, and this gives me the distribution of grades, which is 36.8% of A, 15.8% of B, 36.8% of C, and 10.5% of D. Similarly, this is giving me the count. I have 7 people who have got A, 7 people who have got C, whereas 3 people who have got B and 2 who have got D. So, you can see that this is telling the share of a particular grade, whereas this is giving a count. So, whenever you want to represent data in either a pie chart or a bar chart, the first thing you do is label or annotate your chart. Now, what you see, the horizontal lines here, these are called grid lines. Now, you can also choose whether to have the grid lines or not, that you can go and you can choose again in your data whether you would want to have grid lines or not, and that can be done here. Whether you want the grid lines or not, you can actually choose it here. So, when I have the option of no grid lines, I get a chart without grid lines. Now, suppose I am giving you another data set. Now, if you look at this data set, it tells me that I have about 11 of category A, 6 of category B, about 9 of category C, and about 4 of category D. And I have many, 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 many more categories. Each one of them, they have only one of each such category. Now, where could such data come up from? Now, suppose for example, I am asking some 100 people who is their favorite cricketer. There would be an overwhelming response that Sachin Tendulkar is a favorite cricketer. Some of them might choose Virat Kohli, others might choose say Zaheer Khan, some might choose MS Dhoni. But then afterwards, you will have all these little guys, only two of them might choose say Rahul. Dravid, two might choose KL Rahul, two might choose Ashwin and all of this. So, this is in a sense that the major choice could be the first 4 cricketers and others there. It is not that my entire 100 people are going to only choose among these 4 cricketers, but I have a distribution. So, in this case what you see is when I immediately look at a graph of this kind, I find it too cluttered because there are too many categories. Now, this could also be a case where I am looking at a distribution of industries in particular states. There could be only four states where which sees maximum number of industries, and I have a splutter or splatter of industries in other states. So, now you have too many categories and the bar chart actually looks very cluttered and it is not conveying what I am looking for it to convey. What do we do in these cases? So, a bar chart or pie chart with too many categories might actually conceal the more important categories. So, one way to do it is don't ignore the categories. So, the chart now currently what chart I have not plotted those categories. I have only given a command that plot the bars only if it has more than two counts. So, you can see that all my categories have been which had lesser than two counts have not are not figured in the bar chart at all. What I would suggest is go to a category here where the others are clubbed into a major category. Now, if you do this, it conveys two important things. One is you are not excluding any data, and the second important thing which it conveys is that even though this bar chart says 11 of the total from come from category A, it says that and 9 from category B, what this chart conveys is of the total number you have a significant number that comes from the smaller categories, and that you can see is about 22. So, this gives, so eliminating or not giving this information actually does not give you the entire story. So, this is one way where you can club in all these smaller categories or categories which have very little count to call it as an other category, and this when you portray many categories as an other category, it gives you the entire story.